What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So this intro is being filmed indoors today because yesterday the weather was just so bad that we just had to stop recording outside. So today we're taking a little drive in a Golf R. So before we start the video, guys, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we'll crack on with the video.
It's good power per pound. Power per performance, yeah.
Yeah, it's good value.
Value for performance is good.
I've heard it's not many, it's all bolt on as well, isn't it? It's all bolt on parts and
Yeah, so
map and go.
Because this is basically the Mk5 engine.
Yeah.
But it's just that uprated stock internals, bigger turbo. Well, it's just basically the Wolfsburg team which just got hold of it and
got to town.
Tied it up. So yeah, it knew it cooler. What else was it? Oh, exhaust, obviously. There's sports cat on it for stage two. But like I say, it's all bolt on, so
yeah.
It's not the most expensive job in the world.
No.
No.
So compared to your... I know they're two different cars. The age separates them quite a lot as well. But compared to the GTI, how does this feel on the road?
A lot more modern. And the GTI just feels like a go-kart.
Yeah.
This, in a way, feels like a quicker go-kart, but it's just more refined. Everything on it, I mean, it's like the interior plastics are better quality than the Mk4. But it's an anniversary, end of the day. Can't not love it. I haven't actually driven it since I've got this. I've sawn it now, because I've winning and everything else.
Yeah, exactly.
It's now become a scene coin. So it's undercover.
So just going to use it as a show car now, do you reckon?
Yeah, I'll probably drive it around a bit in the summer, just keep it on the road.
Yeah.
But it was quite funny, yesterday morning was it? I started this up, the cold start on this is ridiculous, and the alarm went off on the Annie next to it.
He's
upstairs.
When you pulled up, I said, I think this has got a deeper exhaust noise than the newer one, I think.
Yeah, I generally regard it as a better R. I think the R20 is probably more raw compared with the newer ones.
Yeah. So the good thing about driving Dan's car is he's not as short as me, but he likes my seating position.
Right, I'm short. Small legs.
Right, there you go. First time at Golf R.
Yeah.
In the dance. Nice.
So take it easy.
First thing I always moan about is the steering, but this feels heavier than. This feels heavy, so heavier than a lot of new modern cars, which I prefer. I think it makes it feel like you feel the road a little bit better.
Yeah, a bit more control.
Yeah,
I know what you mean by the light steering.
Yeah, like, I didn't like that in the Audi.
No, I did the BMW.
Yeah,
it's alright on a daily drive, but when you want to do a bit of hooning around, which we're obviously not doing on a public highway.
No. This is private roads.
Yeah.
And, all these other people are using them. I don't know what they're doing.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting to see how this compares against the Class 4S and the anniversary as well.
Obviously the video is to come. We saw the first video of the Club Sport S, and that was good. It was really good. I really enjoyed that. But it's changed a lot since. I can't believe how well it grips. It's just like
straight up to 50.
Foot down. Gone.
Yeah, it's a good thing about this car. I can't hang around.
No.
I've seen loads of forums on Facebook. They reckon this is a 12-second car down Sandford.
Oh yeah, definitely. I'd say so.
They're probably mistaken too. I'd be amazed if it does that in standard.
You're right. But I think that's how much difference that launch makes. I think having the four-wheel drive just gives you that edge over everyone
on a hot summer's day.
And then
how fast were you going when it went in?
definitely, I'll blame the tyres for that.
I happened to meet that week as well.
Same sort of thing.
Yeah.
So you felt you felt the understeer, and then
you felt,
and then the back yeah. goes.
I think you've got tyres full of grip. I don't think it's going to go that badly.
In the dryer,
but I would say you need better tyres. Yeah, we're all just gonna kill these ones off and get the PS4s, unless they get to March next year and they're still alright. Get rid of them anyway.
Wicked, nice one, Dan. Cheers for
learning
to drive your car again. As we were just talking about, North Coast 500 trip is on the website, so go check that out at www.rlinert.co.uk. And do you want to put any social media on or?
No, I haven't got any for this yet. Okay. It's all on the Annie.
Cool. Awesome. We'll see you in the next video.